Yeah. For your eyes only.
For your eyes.
For your eyes only. For your eyes only.
For your eyes.
For your eyes only. Hey, niggas be dying on the daily. It seems my dreams faded for far too long. The consequences deadly. Can't visualize myself as nothing but a criminal. Control the block, serving up rocks and stay subliminal. Cause young niggas is hard-headed, they letting off. Full of adrenaline, ignorant to what death can cause. Ain't no coming back, family dressed in black. Plus it's hot now, the cops outside. It's hard to flip a pack. And my daughter gotta eat. Her mama be stressing me like I ain't the one who put them J's on her feet. Like I ain't out in the field like that. I might be low for the moment, but I will bounce back despite the charges. Back to the wall, I fight regardless, screaming fuck the law, my life is lawless. That's what you call it, ain't gotta be no psychic to see this is like the farthest thing from heaven. This is hell and I don't mean that hyperbolic. I tried to find employment even if it's wiping toilets, but these felonies be making life the hardest. Resisting the temptation to run up and swipe a wallet, or run up on your yard, snatch your daughter bike and pawn it. That's why I write this sonnet. If the pressure get too much for me to take and I break, play this tape for my daughter and let her know my life is on it.
For your eyes.
Let her know my life is on it.
For your eyes.
For your eyes only.
For your eyes, do you understand? For your eyes, do you understand me? For your eyes, do you understand? For your eyes, do you understand me? For your eyes, do you understand? For your eyes, do you understand me? For your eyes, do you understand? For your eyes.
You probably grown now, so this song will hit you. If you hearing this, unfortunately means that I'm no longer with you. In the physical, not even sure if I believe in God, but because you still alive, it got me praying that the spiritual is real, so I can be a part of you still. My pops was killed too, so I know how part of you feels. Maybe you hate me, maybe you miss me, maybe you spite me. Life goes in cycles, maybe you'll date a nigga just like me. I hope not. I'm tired of dope spots and fiends that smoke rocks. I seen far too many niggas' hopes rot. I'm writing this because me and the devil had a dance. Now I see death around the corner, apologizing in advance. Don't know if I ever had a chance. At a glance, I'm a failure. Addicted to pushing paraphernalia. But daddy had dreams once. My eyes had a gleam once. Innocence disappeared by the age of 8 years. My pops shot up, drug related. Mama addicted, so granny raised me in projects where thugs was hanging. Blood was staining the concrete. Older niggas I love talk like they was above. Maintaining a timesheet, that's slow money. Picked up the family business by the age of 13. 6 years later was handed sentence. Round the same time as when you came in this world. Me and your mama thinking, what the fuck we naming this girl? I told Anina, the prettiest name that I could think of. For the prettiest thing my eyes had ever seen. I was 19, took me 2 felonies to see the trap this crooked ass system set for me. And now I fear it's too late for me to ever be the one to set examples that was never set for me. I'm living fast but not fast enough, cause karma keeps on catching up to me. And if my past becomes the death of me, I hope you understand.
For your eyes, do you understand? For your eyes, do you understand me? For your eyes, do you understand?
Understand.
For your eyes, do you understand me? For your eyes, do you understand?
Understand.
For your eyes, do you understand me? For your eyes, do you understand? For your eyes.
In several ways I could have went out, too many to count. Was it the trigger happy crackers that the badges give clout? Was it the young niggas blasting frustrated cause the cash running out? Niggas don't know how to act in a drought. See baby girl, I realized my definition of a real nigga was skewed. My views misshaped by new mixtapes that confirm the shit I learned in the streets was true. That real niggas don't speak when they beef with you. They just pull up on your street, let the heat hot you. And if a real nigga hungry, he gon' eat your food. I was a fool, spent all my time ducking school, ducking cops, ducking rules, hugging blocks that don't love you. I pray you find a nigga with gold, songs and point of views much broader than the corner. If not, it's gonna corner you into a box where your son don't even know his pops. And the cyclical nature of doing time continues. My worst fear is one day that you come home from school and see your father face while hearing about tragedy on news. I got the strangest feeling your daddy gonna lose his life soon. And sadly, if you listening now, it must mean it's true. But maybe there's a chance that it's not, and this album remains locked in a hard drive like valuable jewels. And I can teach you this in person like I'm teaching you to tie your own shoes. I love you and I hope to God I don't lose you for your eyes on me. One day your daddy called me, told me he had a funny feeling. What he been dealing with lately, he wasn't telling. I tried to pick his brain, still he wasn't revealing. But I could feel the sense of panic in his voice and it was chilling. He said, "Jermaine, I knew you since we was cheering. I never asked for nothing. When times was hard, I never had discussions with you begging you to help me. I dealt with the repercussions of my actions. I know you tried to steer me away from that shit, but that shit was in my blood. You know my life, I know your mama, nigga, send my love. In case I never get a chance to speak again, I won't forget the weekend spent sleeping at your crib. That's the way I wish my family lived, but my granny crib was in the jacks. I had to interject like, nigga, what you talking about? Fuck is you getting at?" He said, "Listen, I got no time to dive into descriptions, but I've been having premonitions. Just call it visions from the other side. I got a feeling I won't see tomorrow, like the time I'm living on is borrowed. With that said, the only thing I'm proud to say, I was a father. Write my story down, and if I pass, go play it for my daughter when she ready. And so I'm leaving you this record for your eyes only. Don't you ever scratch or disrespect it. This perspective is a real one, another lost veil, son. I dedicate these words to you and all the other children affected by the mass incarceration in this nation that sent your pops to prison when he needed education. Sometimes I think this segregation would have done us better, although I know that means that I would never be brought into this world, cause my daddy was so thrilled when he found him a white girl to take back to Jonesboro with Lil Zach and Cole Rare, barely 1 year old. Now it's 30 years later, making sure the story's told. Girl, your daddy was a real nigga, not cause he was cold, not because he was the first to get some pussy 12 years old, not because he used to come through in the caddy on some Vogues, not because he went from bagging up them grams to serving those. Now your daddy was a real nigga, not cause he was hard, not because he lived a life of crime and sat behind some bars, not because he screamed fuck the law, although that was true. Your daddy was a real nigga cause he loved you. For your eyes only.